Jacob to love Rachel. Maybe not so much Leah. And Leah seemed to be overlooked by man. But God didn't overlook Leah. You know what God did? God caused Jacob to have more children through Leah than the other one that Pastor Phil didn't know. Of all the children that Jacob had, Leah gave Jacob 7 children, 6 boys and 1 girl. And Rachel gave him 2 sons. You see, I love how God operates. Leah is a symbol of the forgotten mother, the one who seems to be overlooked, the one that man seems to overlook and culture seems to overlook, but God says, no, you are the mother of all living, and you have great impact in this life. And if anybody knows and if anybody sees, God does. And I love it when God speaks, because when God speaks, I really don't give a hoot who else is talking. You know that? I don't care if a president or the most prestigious person in the room is right. I don't care. Once God spoke, it's like, what did God say? Because that's life and everything. God said, I call you mother of all living. Rise in that. And Leah did. The other mother in the video was Jochebed. Does anybody know Jochebed? Jochebed was the mother of, I'm not going to ask Pastor Phil. Does anybody know, there's any Bible students in the house? First of all, Jochebed, what kind of name is that? But Jochebed, who was Jochebed the mother of? Anybody know? Moses, very good. I know most of you probably said that, but Jochebed was the mother of Moses. And if you remember back then, Pharaoh said to all of the Hebrew midwives to kill all the children, throw them in the river as soon as they were born, because the Israelites were becoming stronger and mightier than the Egyptians. But Jochebed said, I ain't throwing mine in the river. And rather than to do that, she sacrificed Moses. And I couldn't imagine, maybe the mothers could imagine, what would it take to see your child go down the river from your presence and then taken in the arms of another woman, and to have that other woman, to have your child call that other woman mother. Couldn't imagine that. But Jochebed is a picture of the sacrificial mother, the one, the heart of a woman that sacrifices freely so that others could have joy and pleasure in life. How many times have you women sacrificially given to someone, to creation? Because let me tell you women, creation is your child. Creation are your children. And God designed you to be the mother of us all, to sacrificially lay down your wants and your desires for the betterment of the child. You know who else I thought about? And this one here, I thought about, do you remember the story of Solomon, where he just began king and they were testing his wisdom? And there was 2 women and they both had a child. Do you remember the story? And one child died. So the one woman tried to steal the other child, and they went to Solomon claiming both to be the mother of the child. And of course Solomon said, what did Solomon say? Solomon said, cut the child in half and give each mother half of the child. And then what did the true mother say? What did the true mother say? True mother said, let her have the child. And Solomon said, you are indeed his mother. Because the mother has a heart of sacrifice. The woman has a heart of sacrifice. Amen. The woman that was given by God. Know who you are and live in it. God says to the woman, be the woman. Be the woman. Make the sacrifice for the sake of the child, for the sake of creation, for the sake of the culture, for the sake of us all. Amen, everybody.
Amen.
I know God speaks. I think he wants to empower the woman again to say, you know, I know it's a cultural saying, but you are woman, let the earth hear you roar. And it's beautiful in that way. You know, the earth makes it ugly. The earth makes womanhood ugly when it defies men and says woman is better than man. Woman is not better than a man. And a man is not better than a woman. We just have different roles. A woman is not stronger and a man is not stronger. That's disgusting to pit us against each other. It's disgusting. Women have certain strengths and men have certain strengths. We will never be equal. Never be equal. We will always be different. But God tells the woman, you are beautiful, you are powerful, you are the life giver, you are the mother of all of creation. And he says, creation needs a mother, be their mother. Amen. Amen. The next woman in the video, next to last, was Naomi. Some of us know the story of Naomi. If you remember Naomi, what happened to Naomi? Her two sons died and she was left with two daughter-in-laws. You remember that story? Her two sons died, she had two daughter-in-laws. One of the daughter-in-law left, now she has one daughter-in-law. Oops, it's getting really slim now. The daughter-in-law that was left. You remember Pastor Phil, the daughter-in-law that was left? Maybe, yeah, they'll help you out. Yes, all right. You're on sabbatical today. Ruth, I heard 10 Ruths in the house. Ruth. And then Naomi said to Ruth, because even the heart of Naomi, the mother in Naomi, the mother had nobody. The mother, Naomi, she just lost her two sons. She says, I'm a bitter woman. Just call me bitter. I lost my two sons. I just lost my one daughter-in-law. I got one daughter-in-law left. I really don't even know about her. And she says, in sacrifice, she says to Ruth, she gave her permission to go. She said, Ruth, you go home too. That's the heart of a mother. You go home too. You go to your family. But Ruth said to Naomi, I will not leave you. Because she had the same heart. And Ruth said to Naomi, I will never leave you. Where you go, I go. Your people will be my people. Your God will be my God. Wow. Hallelujah. Wow. The heart of a woman, it's beautiful, it's soft, it's tender. Very, very strong. Amen. Very powerful. It's the heart of God. The heart of the woman is the heart of God. And sometimes we can't see God as a woman because we only want to see God as a man. God is not a man. Have you heard? Have you heard? Have you read the Bible? That one's written in black and white because we are, as some say, obtuse. God is not a man. And he doesn't have a gray beard and gray hair. God is not a man. Jesus of Nazareth was a man, but God is not a man. But here's where, you know, there's love and truth. God is not a woman either. He's both. He is both our mother and our father. Can I get an enlightened amen from somebody? Yeah, that's right. The heart of the woman is the heart of God. And then the last mother in the video, I told you if you stay awake, I'll be short. The last mom, Mary, the mother of God, right? This is what I believe God is speaking to us. I believe God finally is rising up in our day, in our age, in our culture, and he's saying, I got something to say. And he says, I designed the woman. I'm going to tell you who the woman is. I'm going to just tell you what a woman is. And the woman is the one who has the heart of a mother. The woman is the one who has the heart for her children, who is compassionate and loving and kind and caring, who is self-sacrificing, who is willing to be forgotten for the sake of their children. Oh, the heart of a mother, the heart of a woman. And God says, I think he's like expanding your role, women, because it's very much needed today. I think he wants to expand your role because it's needed. And I think he wants to tell you, you need to be the mother of all living, not just your own. You need to be the mother of all living. And in essence, what he's saying in the last mother in the video, he says, for you are the mother of God. and you will protect the Christ that is in the earth. And I think God is speaking to the woman. He says, not only nurture the children and nature, and I'm not saying just any children, I'm saying any, because men are children, right? He's saying nurture all of creation. Nurture them. Not only give creation, and can you hear this? Can you hear this? Because it's a big role. Because creation needs a woman, creation needs a mother. Not only nurture all of creation in a physical way, but God also says this. He says, nurture them in a spiritual way also. Be their Naomi. Be their spiritual mother. And when you have an opportunity to speak spiritual things in a situation, speak them. When you have an opportunity to guide someone to Christ and to God, do that. When you're in the middle of a circumstance or a situation, I don't care if it's in your $1 billion job or your $2 shack, makes no difference. The most important role that you have is a mother and a woman. That is the biggest title ever given to a woman, is its mother. Throw your other name tags in the trash can. Put them on fire and then stamp on them. That's how I couldn't get rid of them enough. Oh, silly badges of who we think are and we are and we spend our life. When God said to the woman, you are mother of all. Greatest thing you could be. And God will send you to your jobs. Why? I'll tell you why God's sending you to your jobs. It's not to make money. It's not to be important. You know why God sent you to that job? To be the mother of all living. Nurture them. Comfort them. Affirm them. Bring peace in the home. What's the home? Whatever your job site is, whatever your setting is, whatever your family setting is, be the mother. What does the mother usually do in situations? I tell you, between me and my two brothers, the mother would always want to bring peace, right? Now, boys. My father had none of that. He'd just come and smack us around a little bit. And then when he got bigger, it's like, Dad, not today. We're not going to play this game anymore. Let's not pretend anymore. Short story. I remember one day I said, my dad was going to punish me. I said, Dad, I said, not today. This is what my dad did. Took off his watch. Took off his ring. Got me in the headlock. Anyway, that's the role of a dad. Maybe you'll preach on Father's Day. You know the role of the mother is? She's screaming in the kitchen. Don't let our culture define you, women. You're soft. You're beautiful. You're powerful. The first job you have is to bring peace and comfort into the family, to nurture, to be compassionate, to share experiences. Wherever God sends you, whether you're a nurse or a doctor or an actual mother in a home, you are the woman that God created to mother all of creation. And may I today speak on behalf of creation and say, we desperately need a mother. May we speak on behalf of culture and say, we desperately need a mother. We need a mother. Amen, everybody.
Amen.
Amen. The word of the Lord. Be blessed, women, on this Mother's Day. Know who you are because God created you. No man and woman can tell you who you are. God said so. Praise the Lord. All right, I'm going to ask the praise and worship team to come forward. All right, God bless you all. Why don't you all stand?